My name is Linn Fijal, and today we are at R&B Studio in Stockholm, the studio that I helped build up 10 years ago, where I now work as the studio manager and in-house engineer. When recording vocals, you can always try and experiment. There are a lot of common faults that you don't want in your vocal takes that you can actually avoid by just moving the mic around. Like if you want a close-up sound, you can move close to the mic, but also it affects the rest of the sound, and it can also affect the placement of the vocals in the mix. Even if you compress it or change the volume, you will always hear the proximity to the mic a bit. You can take into consideration that the higher the frequency, the more directed the spread of the sound. So to avoid too much S's, you could, for example, move the mic and go a bit from above and then just angle it towards the mouth of the singer. I'm trying to aim at 45 degrees right now. And this might be a hard angle for the singer to adjust to because they want to sing into the mic because that's natural. So then you can just move the pop shield, or you can place an additional mic right in front. Because it might be more comfortable to sing into something when you're used to that. I tend to record with compression from the beginning, and since all compressors are different and I have some really good ones to choose between, I usually pick the compressors after the sound I want in the end. So I set all the compression before I would add any EQs, and hopefully I don't even have to use the EQs. So when I record vocals, I usually want this warm and compressed sound, but I don't want any pumping. And then my go-to method is to use one old slow, soft compressor to take down the dynamic throughout the song, like the rough edges. And in this case, I'm using the LA2A. And then I pair it with the faster compressor to add some edge and punch in the phrases. And then I'm using the distressor that can be really nice and fast and bright. If I would take the LA2A out, it would probably be too distorted and pumping in the distressor. So it's a good combo for me. Well, they kind of give a texture that I don't think software does. If I didn't have the hardware, like I don't when I mix usually, then I usually just do the same thing, but with software. Everything can be done in software. Then it might take longer time and not be as easy, and you might not get that super touch, but it's doable.